I'm taking you back 12 years to January 20th, 2009. I made a memorable photo at President Obama's inauguration that I certainly will never forget. This is From the Vault. Hey, welcome back. Thanks for joining me. If you don't know who I am, my name's David Bergman. I've been a professional photographer for 30 years now, mostly working in music and sports. On this show, what I like to do is pull old images out of my archive and tell the stories behind the scenes of how I made those photographs. As I'm recording this today, it's January 20th, 2021, and President Biden was just inaugurated as the 46th President of the United States of America. Of course, it brings me back 12 years when I was assigned to cover the inauguration of President Barack Obama, the 44th President of the United States, and I made a picture there that became pretty memorable. Now, I got a photo credential for that through my agency, through Corbis, who was my photo agency at the time, and I was there really to do my traditional photographs, but something I always like to do, and if you know me well enough, you probably know this by now, I like to think of how I can make something different. I knew there were going to be hundreds of the world's best photographers there, and I'm a DC outsider. I don't work in DC. I live in New York City, so I wasn't going to have the kind of access. I wasn't going to be able to work the security like maybe I would have, you know, at a football game or something like that to try to get better access than what was assigned. So I was assigned a spot on the North Media platform of the inauguration, and I knew that's all I was going to have. So the picture that everyone likes to make at an inauguration, the historic photo, is the president with his hand on the Bible and the other hand in the air, taking the oath of office. But since I was going to be on the North platform, there's a North and a South platform, I was going to have the president's back to my head. So the president's back to me, and I was only going to see the back of his head, and I would see the Supreme Court justice, and that's it. So I wasn't going to be able to make that photograph. So I start to think, okay, what can I do that's different here? Why am I here? As a photographer, you should always be thinking, what do you bring to the table? What can you do that's different? Why would a client hire you to make these pictures rather than just picking up a picture from another photographer that's already there? It'd probably be a lot cheaper, and they can know what they're getting before they do it. So if they're going to send you, they're hoping that you're going to do something unique, something different, something to make their money worth spending. So because I knew about a month beforehand, I started doing research on what I could do. Now, of course, it was a big story that this was the first African-American president in U.S. history, which was amazing. And that, you know, for that, you want that typical swearing-in photo. But I wasn't going to be able to do that. So what else? Well, the other part of this story was that there were going to be a lot of people there. They were saying anywhere from 1 to 2 million people were going to be at this inauguration. So I wanted to show that size crowd. I've been to a lot of big events, Olympics and Super Bowls, and I've never seen a crowd of 2 million people. So I wanted to document that in some way. So I started doing research on different kinds of technology. Remember, this was 12 years ago, so there wasn't a lot of tech to do these kinds of panoramic photos, but I came across this company called Gigapan, and they had new technology that actually was invented by a bunch of really smart scientists who worked on the Mars rover program. If you've ever seen those pictures from the surface of Mars, where it's like multiple images stitched together to make a bigger picture, the people who actually invented that technology then licensed that to this company called Gigapan, where they built a robotic camera mount that was available for consumers. And basically how it works is you put your camera in it, a regular camera, you zoom in as far as possible so you can get the most resolution, and then the Gigapan unit will move the camera, and you can even set it to take the pictures automatically. So it will automate that movement, so it's very consistent. So therefore, I mean, you could already do this manually, but by doing it consistently and then using their stitching software as well, it makes it a lot easier to shoot potentially hundreds of photographs. So I called the company up and I said, you know, has this technology ever been used where there are people? Because really it had been only used on landscapes, and they were kind of like, nope. But they said, you know, I told them I was doing the inauguration, and they said, oh, we'll send you a loaner unit if you want. I was like, sure, why not? I'll try it out. I don't know how much faith I had that would actually work, but I figured I'd give it a shot. So the day of the inauguration, I actually brought it. And by the way, the only unit they had back then was a very small unit. It was their first model, and it only took a point-and-shoot camera. So I was going to use the Canon G10 point-and-shoot in there, and then this unit. Today, there are bigger units that'll take big cameras, but back then, that's all they had. So the day of the inauguration, I remember it being super cold, and you had to walk miles to get to the Capitol and go through multiple layers of security, obviously, to get in there. And then once I was in, I had a tripod with me, but there just wasn't enough room to set that up because we're packed in there, all the photographers are. So I also had brought a magic arm and a super clamp, and I basically clamped it to the railing on the media platform. And some other photographer was lucky enough for me to take a photograph of that, probably with an old phone at the time. Well, maybe it was a real camera, but So I'm fortunate to have a photograph. For some reason, I never took a picture of the setup, but this is what it looks like. And it was, I had it maybe 6 feet from me. I couldn't quite get close enough to it the way that was set up, but I have it balancing a bit precariously on there. I wish they had made it with something that I could put a safety cable, but I couldn't really figure out a way to do that. So anyway, I think I had it balanced in a way so that if it did fall or break, it would fall backwards onto the platform instead of into the crowd below. So anyway, I set that thing up. But for me, my thought process was, this is kind of a sidebar thing. I'm doing my real photographs. This is what I'm here to do. I'm locked in a spot, so I can't really, you know, that's all I can shoot. But this is what my view looked like from the platform. And, you know, certainly great crowd, lots of people. As you look back the other direction, just people as far back as you can see, which really was amazing. So I went on doing my regular photographs and, you know, ignored the GigaPan at the very beginning. But then eventually I turned it on and I started it going. And basically what you do is you set the parameters. You set the top left and the bottom right, and you program in your focal length, your field of view, and then it sort of calculates it. But I let that go on the side and I was making my real photographs. So these are the pictures from the actual event. Of course, all the former presidents, the living presidents were there, the Clintons, Bush Senior, Bush 41, right, and his wife Barbara, and Jimmy Carter and Rosalind Carter were there. It really was quite amazing to see all of these people together. And then Michelle Obama and now First Lady Biden was there, Dr. Biden. And so they were all obviously together. Everybody was very cordial, very different time in US history. But it was nice to see outgoing President Bush 43, certainly welcoming Michelle Obama and the Obama family, you know, looking on as President Obama and Vice President-elect Biden were also sitting by. So these are the kind of pictures I was making. And then the actual swearing in, of course, Vice President Biden. Again, I'm in the wrong position to really make this photograph. I'm still going to shoot it, but it's not really that great of a photograph since it's the back of the important people's head. But then now President Biden kissed Dr. Biden, of course, and thanked the crowd. And then we moved on to the main event, Justice Roberts swearing in President Obama with his family there. And then when I'm doing this, I want to shoot wide, I want to shoot tight, I want to give myself as many options as I can. So at this point, I really had the GigaPan going in full force. Now, that unit only had a built-in battery that you had to plug in to recharge, so I couldn't swap out batteries. And it was really cold that day, so it lasted about 4 or 5 and a half passes. Basically, it would go, it would do its thing, and then it would end, and I would, as soon as I could get over there and just hit, you know, go again. There's a menu setting where you can just say repeat the last panorama. So I would do that, and then eventually until it died and I couldn't do it. But I want to give you an idea of what those pictures look like. This is just grabbing a few of them. So you can see, basically, I was shooting top to bottom. If I was doing this again, this was my first GigaPan. If I was doing this again, I might have gone horizontally, but in this case, I chose to go left to right and have it shoot top down. So just a little portion of it, as you can see, I was going here, here, and this is obviously as we get into the crowd and then the president speaking. This is while he was giving his address to the crowd. And then down, you can see the band. And then of course the photographers who are in front of me. And then one row over, same thing from the top down. And these overlap with the images that I shot before so that you can get, the stitching will work much better when it stitches them all together. The thing is, people have seen this picture since then and they think it's some crazy high-res camera or something like that. But I want to show that this is a typical example of, this is one of the frames from that GigaPan. This is full resolution. And then if you zoom in at 100%, you can see it's pretty good resolution. This is not a digital zoom. This is what it looks like at 100% from that Canon G10. So you stitch all those together and you're going to wind up with a large photograph. Now, Now, it's funny as you go through this event. I mean, if you remember, it was a huge event. Every celebrity, every politician, everybody wanted to be there. So there are some fun things in the crowd. Like you can see all the celebrities. You can see here's one of my favorites with Yo-Yo Ma, who played the, I don't remember what song he played before as the inauguration started, but, you know, famous, well-respected cellist, and he's taking a picture with his iPhone. That was actually the first generation iPhone at that time, which I thought was really funny. You can go in here and you can see Denzel Washington and P. Diddy or Puff Daddy or whatever he was going by at the time. I mean, every celebrity in the world was there. And then, of course, as the inauguration ended, I had to make a selfie of myself with my Bare Naked Ladies hat on just so I could remember the moment. This was with a real camera. We didn't have really good cell phones. I don't even know if I had the iPhone 1 yet. It was out, but I didn't have it right away. So after the inauguration, I packed everything up. As I was walking away, I could see President Bush's helicopter as he was leaving DC. So I grabbed a quick frame of that, and I kind of like this where he's heading away and you can see the Washington Monument. And then you get in position to cover the parade. This year they're doing the parade. They did the parade a little bit differently, a lot of virtual events, but normally they parade down the street and it's a big celebration and everybody kind of goes crazy. And so I was making pictures at the parade, and then what you really want is the president to get out of the car. He would get out of the car sometimes and walk for a block or two, then get back in the car with his family. And it was just bad luck that when he passed me by, he was in the car. I was really kind of bummed about that. So it's really the only kind of picture I could get. But then Vice President Biden actually happened to get out of the car and walk down the street when he passed me. So that was really nice, especially now that he is actually the president. So that was really cool to have those. Now, at the end of the day, I'm exhausted. I get back to my hotel room. I start editing all my photographs, and I remember, oh yeah, that GigaPen. Let's see if it made anything. So I took the SD card and put it in the computer and got the stitching software, the GigaPen stitching software, open, and I laid it out. Now, what I had shot is actually 20 frames across by 11 frames down. So it's 220 images. And when I put it in the stitching software, this is what it looks like. And I kind of looked at that and I went, yeah, that's gonna be pretty cool. Remember, each one of those frames is a full resolution G10 image. So that's gonna give me a really, really big frame when that stitches them together. So it was the end of the day, and the stitching software wasn't as fast. The computers weren't as fast as they are now. So I just started it overnight and let it go. And it took about 6.5 hours to stitch. In the morning when I got up, it was done. And I wound up with one frame. And this is what it looks like as a single frame. Now this image is, a normal photograph is what, 20 megapixels, 25, even 50 megapixels is massive, right? This image is 1,474 megapixels. If you actually look at the pixel dimensions, if you're curious, it's 59,783 across by 24,658 down. So that is a very, very large photograph. The file, the TIFF file saved out, is just under 2 gigabytes. So again, the computers back then were really slow. So just opening that file and trying to do anything with it was really, really difficult. But I was able to get what I needed, and then I uploaded it to the GigaPen servers, and they have software built in where you can embed that, where so that you can zoom in. It's kind of like Google Maps, where as you zoom in, it pops more into focus. So I uploaded that, and I went home the next day, and basically, at that time, Facebook was brand new. I had a blog, and I just posted it on my blog and went on Facebook and said, hey, check this thing out. I think it's pretty cool looking. What do you think? And it spread like wildfire. This thing went viral before that was a thing, and not in the bad way viral. It really went crazy. Within a few days, it had 1 million views. Then they interviewed me on CNN, and it just blew up. My site went down for a couple hours after that CNN interview. And this thing was publicized everywhere. Every photo publication, every political publication, every tech publication, online, print, everything. It went crazy. I mean, it really, for at least for 4 years after that, if you Googled the generic phrase, inauguration photo, my blog was the first thing that came up. So it really went nuts over the course of time. Last I checked, it had over 30 million views. So really, really went nuts. It was just this combination of perfect storm of a giant event and using technology in a different way to create something. I was getting emails from people all around the world who were saying, I'm getting nothing done at work because I'm zoomed into this picture and just looking at all the faces in the crowd. People were finding celebrities, they were finding their friends, people who were there obviously were finding themselves. It really was a kind of a cool thing. So that's the story of how I made that photograph. You've probably seen it. The funny thing now is all these years later, it sometimes comes back around where I'll get an email from a friend of mine who says, oh, my crazy cousin sent me this email and it says basically, look at what the KGB is doing, or look at what the foreign governments are doing. They're spying on us. They have this technology that we don't have in the US. And it's just insane because obviously once my friend gets it, they know that it's my picture. So they send it and they say, look what you caused. So anyway, it's a bit nuts, but today's inauguration just made me, want to look back at this image. What I'm doing with this From the Vault series, I always offer fine art prints of my photographs, usually 11 by 14. This image, obviously a bit special, 11 by 14 just isn't going to work. So I am offering one giant size of this photograph. It's actually 3 feet by 6 feet wide. It's 36 by 72 inches. So it's a giant print. I am signing it as well, but you can get that at davidbergmanphoto.com. If you're interested, this is kind of a one-of-a-kind photograph. I've got the logo, an inauguration logo up there in the giant white sky. So it really looks cool when it's that big on your wall. So if you want to get that, check that out at davidbergmanphoto.com. Again, I'm doing this every week. I'm pulling images out. I hope you'll join me back here on my YouTube channel next week. Give me a thumbs up, give me a like, subscribe, comment down below if you want, and we can get the conversation going. So thanks for joining me. I'll see you back here next week on From the Vault.